Now, of course, I say of course just because timing is perfect, right? But I think it's just something that's always there. It doesn't matter about what we're going through right now, 2020. It could be 2040. It could be 1986. It could be 1700s. What you're saying is essential. Where were you when you had to write that, when you had to push that? What was pushing you to kind of like let that flow?
Absolutely. Well, first and foremost, thank you so much, King Lee, for allowing me to be a part of your broadcast. And I love the fact that you are giving an artist an opportunity to reflect and showcase their creativity. That's huge. That's really, really big what you're doing. You know, I wrote Queen Revolutionary as a testimony of my inner revolution. Because what I believe, King, is the soul work is the real work. Right? And what we believe about ourselves is what we become. And I went on a deep soul journey, mind, body, soul, spirit. It's a continuous journey. Just like you said, I could have wrote this song years, you know, ahead, in the past. If I come back, whatever, the song will still be here. Because as human beings, the internal work is so important. So I wrote Queen Revolutionary as a testimony of me just breaking free to my dimension as a woman. You know what I mean? And also empowering other people to do the same. Remove the self-doubt. Everything you need is already within you. Completely, let's tap into our power, because we've been so conditioned, we've been so traumatized as people, as all people, to be honest, that we don't even know what we carry. So it's like I am on a mission to create powerful music, poetry, creative content, film, speaking, you name it, to empower people to become their highest authentic self. And I took a huge jump because I left my job last year as a local TV anchor to create my own multimedia company called Motivation No More, aimed to elevate the human consciousness. I want to create powerful content to empower people to believe in their infinite potential. And I'm so fortunate for, you know, people like you who understand the importance of artists just emerging themselves in their calling and in their art. So thank you.
No, definitely. And I love how you even outlined that, because that is, wow, that's a book right there. That's chapter, that's just, that's that. What chapter is that? Actually, perfect question. All right, Queen Revolutionary.
Yeah.
Like you said, we're constantly, it's a constant journey. So what chapter are you? Do you know the chapter that you're in? What chapter would you say?
That's a good question.
Okay.
You know what, to be honest, King, I know this sounds crazy. I've done a lot in my career, right? A lot. But to be honest, the chapter of me right now, I don't even know what chapter I am on, but one thing I know for sure, I'm on a higher realm.
Okay.
Because it's like so deep when you are just owning who you are unapologetically. Right. And let me tell you, it takes so much courage. Like, it's not easy. And it's so crazy when you think about it, because I'm way more free than most people, but I'm still not 100% like, woo! But it takes courage to be your authentic self. And it's like, when you think about it, you're like, what? This is ridiculous, but it's the reality. Yeah. And then sometimes it's like, you know, I can be hard on myself, but one thing I'm realizing is human beings will always be human. You know what I mean? So I don't even know what journey I am on, like what chapter, but all I can say is I'm on a higher realm and I am tapping into this power, scared, not having everything figured out, but I'm trusting God in my divine vision, and I'm creating works of art that speak true to my soul. And that's the thing about art. Like, there's 7 billion people in this world. So whatever you create, there's a lane, an audience for you. Right. And at first, I'll be honest, I was a little bit hesitant about putting my art out there because, you know, I'm a former, you know, TV anchor. Mm-hmm. And it's like my lane is so different. You know, I like poetry and I'm going to put it with music and this and that. And I said, you know what? This is me. And on a deeper perspective, King, think about it. Every single thing was invented by someone.
I love it.
Put ourselves in boxes like this little There was no cell phone. There was no social media. So why not we, as artists, create what we want to see in the world?
Ooh.
Come on, King.
She just stepped on the podium. Okay. I could talk for hours, but this is my last question. All right. So I'm gonna go off that what you just said. Ooh, you talking about because you said a lot. I'm trying to think because you talked about creating, right? And I want to pertain more personally to you because I know how that is coming from like a business world, a corporate world where it's structure, it's identity of who you are and how you should be. Is there some from seeing you evolve to now? Of course, it's been the changes, but is there one particular thing you would say this I let go and threw in the trash can, and you're so glad you got that, you were able to break out that mold.
You know what? I think that's a great question. I think what I had to do in order to get there was kind of just have a boundless type of mindset. Like, okay, we've been in conditioned in boxes, whether right. that's corporate America, whether that's environment, whether that's what we're taught. And I'm forcing myself to get outside of that box. Mm. And once I did that, it's like I took that step outside of the matrix. And then I'm realizing the infinite power and potential in me. See, getting outside of what, you know, everybody thinks is, you know, like just what it is.
Right.
You bring a whole new sense of yourself that you didn't even realize. Mm. And that is because you took the time to do the soul work and the internal work. And, you know, for the viewers, it's very, very, very important. Viewers, listeners, let me tell you, take the time to really discover who you are. What makes you happy? What do you like to do? What excites your soul? And right. only you can define that.
Right.
And it will change and it will heighten, and enjoy the journey of becoming your highest authentic self.
Oh, wow. Wow, yes. That just gave me goosebumps.
I'm telling you.
No, that's real. No, thank you. Thank you.
This platform. And tap into it. And this is just one of the things that you're going to be doing. The more you tap into Lee, you're going to start doing this. You're going to start doing this. Because you are walking in your power. And the moment you're not even looking for external forces, the moment you're like, I'm just doing this for myself, you won. Because the opportunities, the people who are meant to connect with you will happen. Because there's so much power in walking in your light. It's literally light.
Yes. And that's
but it takes courage.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage. Because you end up losing friends, you end up losing some maybe family members, all these different things that you were attached to. Thank you. What else do you have? Was this part of another project, or was this part of it? What all? Because I mean, your motivation, it's one thing, you know, that's what you call real talk right there, because a lot of people give motivation speeches, but it's only a few words that people say to actually make your skin like vibrate. Yes. So what all is this like? How is this being packaged?
Absolutely. So right now I'm working on an album. Working on the album. I actually have an IG show coming up on September 4th. It's called Freedom. Nice. It's a mixture of my music and my poetry to uplift people to become their highest authentic self and elevate the mind, body, soul, and spirit. So I'm also working on a documentary because I truly have a passion for storytelling and a course as well, you know? So what I realize is my creativity is boundless. I'm going to take the gifts that God has blessed me with and I'm going to package it.
Nice.
I'm going to package it because we can create anything. We can create movies, like we can create songs, we can create anything. Yeah. And this is something that I encourage us creatives to do, is realize that not only do we have a gift, but we also have the opportunity to create wealth. But the only way that's going to happen is if we believe in our power and surrender to the process of a higher elevation. And that takes time, it takes dedication, it takes consistency, it takes self-belief, because this journey is not easy. I can't tell you how many times I've had breakdowns, like, oh, and then, okay, God, let's do this. You know what I mean? Because I am human. And I think a lot of times, especially like motivational speakers and stuff, they don't talk about that stuff. They make it seem like life is all roses.
Right.
That is not reality. So, you know, I'm very real, and I just want to encourage people to follow their bliss and follow their joy. And I'm going to do that through creating content. And let me tell you something.
Let's go.
Great. ready.
Let's go.
I'm taking this creativity to the next dimension.
Yes. Ooh.
So I thank you for allowing me to be on your show.
1000%, because hey, you got supporters, more supporters, new supporters. Hey, we got to keep pushing each other. So thank you. I'm gonna shout out your Instagram. I'm gonna shout out are you on Twitter?
Yes.
Okay, is it the same thing as your Instagram?
Yeah. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, charlottemoore.com, motivationalmoore.com. Follow my business, Motivational More. We're a multimedia and communications company elevating the human consciousness. We create powerful content on multiple platforms. And kings and queens, continue to step into your power.
Ooh, thank you. Well, I'm gonna send this to you once it's finished this weekend, and thank you, and I look forward to see what else you put together.
Yes, thank you.
All right, much love and light. Peace.
Blessings.